This need for customization and the opportunity for customization is what spurred operating system designers to think of a structure of the operating system that would allow customization of the services and gave birth to the idea of microkernel-based operating system. As before, each of the applications is in its own hardware address space. The microkernel runs in a privileged mode of the architecture and provides simple abstractions such as threads, address space, and inter-process communication. In other words, small number of mechanisms are supported by the microkernel. The key word is mechanisms. There are no policies ingrained in the microkernel, only mechanisms for accessing hardware resources. The operating system services, such as virtual memory management, CPU scheduling, file system, and so on, they're implemented as servers on top of the microkernel. So in other words, these system services execute with the same privilege as the applications themselves. Each of the system service is in its own address space, and it is protected from one another and protected from the application, and the microkernel, being below this red line, is running in privileged mode. It is protected from all of the applications as well as the system services. So in other words, we no longer have that monolithic structure that we had before. Instead, each operating system service is in its own hardware address space. In principle, there is no distinction between regular applications and the system services that are executing as server processes on top of the microkernel. Thus, we have very strong protection among the applications, between the applications and system services, among the system services, and between application system services and the microkernel. Now, the structure, what it entails is that you need the microkernel to provide inter-process communication so that the applications can request system services by contacting the servers, and the servers need to talk to one another as well. And in order for them to talk to one another, they need inter-process communication as well. So what have we gained by the structure? What we have gained by the structure is extensibility. Because these OS services are implemented as server processes, we can have replicated server processes with different characteristics. For instance, this application may choose to use this particular file system. Another application may choose to use a different file system. No longer do we have that one-size-fits-all characterization of the monolithic kernel. And this is the biggest draw for the microkernel-based design, that it is easy to extend the services that are provided by the operating system to customize the services depending on the needs of the application. This all sounds good, but is there a catch?